Next was one of the most awesome experiences of our entire trip. The driver took us to a Zulu village in the mountains, and we joined in worship at a church that was held in the tent. Their youth choir ministered in song, and then the floor was given to Pastor Chen, who then turned it over to covePRAISE to minister in song. Immediately upon singing, the entire tent went up in praise. It was amazing. The worship of Jesus Christ filled the atmosphere, and we were engulfed in God's presence. It was unlike anything we had ever experienced before. Then Pastor Kevin got up to give a brief exhortation from the Word. He needed an interpreter, so the pastor got up beside him to interpret Pastor Kevin's words. This was the first for Pastor Kev, but the power of God filled him and he spoke with authority. Afterwards, we ended in more song and praise. We desired greatly to sow into their ministry, and the U.S. team took an offering and gave generously. The pastor was absolutely overwhelmed. The team was then invited to a room next door, and while we were in there, the sound of music and high praise and the dance emanated from the tent. Steve said, "I'm going back out there to see what's going on." Eventually, we all left back out and found the youth and the church in a traditional Zulu dance of pure energy and enthusiasm.
It was actually a blessing to be able to, fellowship with our Zulu brothers and sisters, because we didn't think we'd be able to at first. But getting there, you know, it was in a tent, but God's presence was definitely felt there, especially the love that they had. So their youth choir got up and sang some songs, and then we got up there and sang some songs as well. And Pastor Kevin Early got up and preached a word with his interpreter.
Not desiring to leave, we loaded up and took off. Pastor Chen proceeded to say, "Man, if this whole trip was for that one service, it was worth it." The team agreed profusely. This church had completely captured our hearts. Monday, we joined up to go to the game park, which is a place where the wild animals roam free. So with Pastor Pillay as our guide, we drove to Tala, Durban's finest game reserve. Lion Park, where lions roam free. It's very dangerous, so we had to use extreme caution.
That's a roadblock. Jesus.
The lions were very tired and exhausted from the South African sun. But the experience of seeing them right outside the van was highly interesting and invigorating. Tuesday, shopping day. We were able to go to some malls to get some items and souvenirs, and even go to a marketplace right across the street from our hotel. Then we departed for our final church ministry that evening. We were excited as we traveled to an Indian church in a Durban suburb. God's presence filled that atmosphere, and we went after God in praise and worship. Then the floor was given to Pastor Chan, who preached from the Word of God. Then covePRAISE joined in with the church's music team, and we sang unto the Lord in more praise and worship, and just enjoyed the presence of God. The U.S. team flew almost 9,000 miles to fellowship, dance, praise, and worship Jesus Christ with their Christian brothers and sisters of a different culture. Indeed, their lives were transformed by this life-changing experience.
But actually getting a chance to minister and pour out and to be poured into. Oh, you know, but we, overall, man, on a scale of 1 to 10, this trip, 11.
Though they worship in their own ways, we also see parts of the worship in our culture, and it was beautiful.
I'm so happy we can go back and say we have experienced God's presence in another continent.
Awesome.
And God is good. It is awesome. Yes, Phillip, it is awesome.
Yes.
And I will do it again.
Going to the hospital, going to the orphanage, been fun, it's been sad, but I think what it has done is brought us right back down to the ground where we need to be, and that's out of our comfort zones when we serve God.
We got a chance to participate with the praise team,
yes.
And Phillip had a jam session with the band.
We just
enjoyed ourselves. Stevie was there, he's a celebrity here in Durban. I don't know how that happened. But
one of my favorite parts of the trip was when we went to the Zulu church.
All right, that's 4 for 4.
We would not have been here if it weren't for the grace of God and everybody's prayers.
Shout outs to Pastor Pillay.
Woo-hoo!
Thank you for enduring us for a week. Woo!
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. Just the fact that we were able to combine both praise teams and everybody else was like on one accord, just praising God. So that was refreshing.
Yeah.
It was very different. And then even last night was an awesome experience as well. Just can't wait to do it again.
Relationships
with the youth, the conference went great.
We can only hope and pray that the Lord Jesus Christ will once again open the door for covePRAISE to minister overseas to the hearts of many. There is no one.